Campaign headquarters here. Just one moment, please. This is Ollie's campaign office. Dolph's appearing on television. Yes, we shall see it later on, then. Speak to you later. Dolph speaking on television now.
And this street is cut off too, Ollie.
We'll take the train, then.
That'll take even more time.
Well, I don't mind running late. I have something I must discuss with the constituents in that area. I only need 5 minutes.
Your speeches never end on time, Ollie, because you keep going on and on once you start talking.
Oh, a terrible thing has happened.
What is it, then?
Dolf is speaking on TV right now.
That's Dolf, all right.
Well, to repeat what I said, yes, you can rest assured I intend to get to the scene just as soon as I can. But in the meantime,
I have declared that I will donate all the sand and rock and cement at my company's warehouse, free of charge. And I'm bringing my election campaign to an end, which means I can devote myself to heading the construction effort, because this emergency is too great for me to worry about elections.
I ask all my supporters to be at the scene to help me with the work. Thank you all, but I must get to the scene myself now.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, Dolf is now quickly leaving his campaign headquarters. And in our national emergency, Dolf's remarkable statement will be highly regarded by the...
Can Dolf be serious?
Providing construction materials free of charge, devotion to the relief effort, stopping his campaign. He's up to something.
Up to what?
Well, it's just typical Dolf. And I have no doubt he's just trying to give a boost to his election chances.
It was a smart idea to offer construction materials.
That's my point, Ollie. I don't think he obtained those materials legally.
And it's strange a flood occurs just 1 week before election day.
Huh? That's it, Ollie. Damage to the breakwater. That's suspicious, because nothing like that has happened in that area before. And those breakwaters can stand up to anything!
Do you mean Dolf might have caused the flood on purpose? That's a terrible thought.
Yes, but Dolf is quite capable, and I'll do the best I can to find some hard evidence this time.
Due to the quick response from Dolf and other volunteers, the threat of more serious disaster has passed. But damage has been heavy, and casualties now stand at 26. Dolf has now resumed his election campaign with only 1 day left before voting takes place. The main point of interest now seems to be Dolph's gallant gesture. Only time will tell how much his work in the relief effort has influenced the outcome of this election. And it
he
does
will become
seem
more popular.
The bandwagon for Dolf is now moving very heavily in his direction.
Good evening, Dolf. You're rather late for your appointment, aren't you?
Oh, you know how busy I've been today, surely, Lispel.
So what? The information which I have today will be worthless as time goes by. So pay me first.
I don't have the money.
You what?
Once I start paying you, you'll never get off my back. I know that well.
Oh, no, I'm not like that. You just pay me, and I'll be on my way. Hey, what are you doing with that gun?
The time's up, Lispel.
Don't shoot. You don't have to pay.
Huh? Huh?
Here in Poldertown at polling center number 3, people are queuing to vote. Only time will tell who is going to be this country's first president.
Seemed to me that all the people at the polling center were voting for Dolf.
So? You think so? I voted for Dolf too.
Sorry, Hank. I'm not in the mood for jokes.
I don't think all the people are stupid enough to be deceived by Dolf's cheap trick.
Ah, but I'm afraid that our problem is that we have to have proof.
Hey, look, what's that?
Is it Lispel?
Where have you been? I've been waiting a long time.
Gosh, you look badly hurt. Whatever happened?
If you want to know what happened to me, I want you to pay me one gold coin. No, half will do for this information.
Hey, Harry! Are you home, Harry? Is Harry here? Where is Harry? Have you seen Harry around? I'm looking for Harry. Do you know where Harry is?
I'm asking you this just in case, but does everyone here know that today's election day?
We voted for you, Dolf.
Well, I know of one man so busy working for the campaign that he's forgotten to vote at all. My heartfelt thanks for your wonderful support. See you soon.
Hooray for Dolf!
Goodbye, President Dolf.
Thank you, but a bit early for that, eh?
I'd like to see Harry, please, Dolf.
Harry? What for? Eh?
If he's here, I want him.
Well, you've got a cheek. He's not here.
So where is he?
Don't know. I don't know anything about that coward.
You do know where he is?
Hey! What do you think
come
you're
out,
doing?
Harry, come out! I've got a vital message for you!
Throw the duck out! Throw him out!
Are you really sure that Harry wasn't at Dolph's office?
I heard he hadn't turned up there for 4 or 5 days. A man at the office who isn't on good terms with Dolf anymore, he told me that.
That's a big problem. We must find Harry before Dolf can harm him.
Oh, no. Will Dolf be elected president after all? Could you please see who that is, Dad? I'd rather not talk to anyone.
Oh. Hmm? Harry?
Wow!
Over 20 people were killed in that flood. But Dolf doesn't give a hang about it. And the country will be ruined if that cold-blooded devil becomes president. I realise that now.
Couldn't you have done something?
Yes, I feel terribly ashamed of myself. I'm afraid I didn't have the courage. On the one hand, I felt bad about the awful things we'd done. But on the other hand, I couldn't help following Dolf, as he was considered the most likely to be elected president. Then today I heard you were looking for me and I thought you knew everything.
Lispel saw it all. But even if Dolf is elected president, he won't be able to take office if you testify against him. So let's go to the police right away, Harry.
Hello.
Good morning, President.
The results already?
Of course not. They haven't started counting yet.
Do you mind letting me sleep then?
You have no time to sleep, Dolf. The police are coming for you.
Who is that speaking?
Oh, have you forgotten my voice, Dolf? I'm calling you from heaven.
Lispel, you're still alive.
I'm sorry, Dolf. Harry went to Alfred's house late last night, and then they went to the police.
Ah, what's that?
The police will be knocking on your door any minute.
Ah!
There they are, right on
this
time.
This is the police. Open up, Dolf. We know you're in there.
What do you mean, Alfred? It's only a forecast, but all Ollie is in the lead.
Really? It won't be Dolph then.
No, Ollie is the first, and then there's Nox, and Dolph is the last of all.
Oh.
The voters were clever enough then to choose the right candidate.
That really is terrific, Alfred.
Yippee! Yippee!
No, no, no! I should be the legitimate president.
Ollie's victory is now confirmed, and Dolph is wanted by the police on several charges, including murder.
Lies!
We congratulate Mr. Ollie, who is Waterland's first democratically elected president. That is the end of this bulletin. Good night to you all.
Alfred is so merry, so very, very merry. He's even bright and cheerful if things are going wrong. Whenever he's downhearted, 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 the feeling's never with him for very, very long. Young Alfred is quite sporty, he likes to be quite sporty. He's very much like any normal, lively lad. Sometimes he can be naughty, but even when he's naughty, you'll find he's never, never, ever really bad. And you've been with us and heard our refrain. We'll hope you come along soon and join us again.